I am Megha Verma, student of B.Sc 5th sem autonomous PG college Chhindwara. Today's object is to plot the reverse and forwards characteristic curve of photodiode at different intensity of light level. To conduct this experiment, we require DC regulated power supply of 0 to 3 volts, a voltmeter ranges from 0 to 3 volt of DC, an ammeter. We can set its value at 50 microampere or 5 milliampere as per our choice. A photodiode mounted in a steel cabinet, a lamp with lamp holder, graduated wooden stand and some connection wires, etc. Figure shows the construction of planar diffused silicon photodiode. Photodiode is normally a PN junction diode, but in photodiode, more impurities are present as compared to PN junction diode. This is the P plus region and this is the N plus region. The area between the P type impurities and N type impurities are known as depletion region. Here depletion region is represented by yellow color. Some portion of the front areas is called active area diameter, which is coated with anti-reflection material in order to reduce the reflection of light. This terminal shows anode and this terminal shows cathode. Here is the symbol of photodiode. The incoming arrows represents the incident light. Photodiode consumes light energy to produce electric current. It can be operated in reverse and forward biasing, but generally it is operated in reverse biasing the junction and then illuminating it. This is the arrangement diagram of today's apparatus. This is the photodiode. Here the incident light falls on the depletion region, and for this we use a convex lens so that the light must fall on the depletion region. We connect this photodiode in reverse biasing, that means P region is connected to the negative terminal and N region is connected to the positive terminal. The whole photodiode is covered with plastic shield in order to protect it from any damage. This is the construction diagram of PN junction diode. This is the P region. Here majority charge carriers are holes, which is shown by orange color, and here immobile ions are negative. While in N region, majority charge carriers are electron, which is shown by solid green color, and immobile ion are positive. We have also represents the minority charge in P and N regions. We can see no free charge is present in depletion region. Here only purely neutral atoms or immobile ions are present. When we connect the PN junction diode in reverse biasing, that is P region is connected to the negative terminal and N region is connected to the positive terminal, then we can see a fixed amount of current, that is leakage current, flows due to the minority charge carriers in P and N region. This leakage current is represented by IG and it is independent of the applied voltage. If we want to increase the value of IG, then for this we can incident external light on depletion region. As light incident on the depletion region, then we can see the immobile ions or neutral ions that are present here again starts ionizing because of these electron hole pairs are developed in maximum amount. Because of these newly generated electron hole pairs, maximum amount of current flows through the external circuit and this current is called photocurrent. If the value of current flows through the external circuit is represented by I, then I is equals to Is plus IV. Photodiode can turn its current on and off in nanoseconds, hence it is the fastest photodetectors. It is used to switch light on and off at maximum rate, hence it is used as ultra-fast switch. I am going to perform this experiment, that is to draw forward and reverse characteristic curve with the help of this apparatus. This is the voltage control knob. By moving it clockwise, we can vary the applied voltage. This is the voltmeter. It ranges from 0 to 3 volt and its least count is 0.05 volt. This is an ammeter, which we can set at 50 new ampere and 5 milliampere as per our choice. This photodiode is connected with these points. This is a lamp and it is adjusted in such a way that the light incident from it must straightly fall to the photodiode. These are placed on a wooden stand by which we can measure the distance between them. This is the voltmeter's positive and negative terminal. It is attached to the positive terminal of the voltmeter as shown in figure. This is ammeter's positive and negative terminal. It is attached as it is to the positive and negative terminal of the ammeter. The positive terminal of the supply is connected to the circuit and the negative terminal of the supply is connected to the circuit. As we are going to performing for reverse biasing, therefore the positive terminal of the photodiode is connected to the negative terminal of the photodiode, which is shown in circuit, and its negative terminal is attached to the positive terminal. Now I am going to connect this circuit to the photodiode. Now we have to place this lamp and photodiode in a fixed separation. Here I already adjust it. I am adjusting it at 18 cm. I already adjust it in separation of 18 cm and we have to cover them since no other light will fall on its surface. So I am going to cover this. Now we are going to take the readings. Firstly, set the voltage using the voltage control knob at 0 volt and note down the reading of current. At 0 volt, ammeter shows 0.6 milliampere. At 0.25 volt, ammeter shows 0.6 milliampere. At 0.5 volt, ammeter shows again 0.6 milliampere. You can see up to 1.4, ammeter shows the same reading. But at 1.4, the ammeter shows 1.1 milliampere. At 1.4 volt, ammeter shows 1.1 milliampere of current. After this, therefore, we have to take some precautions and carefully note down the reading of current. At 1.5 volt, ammeter shows 1.5 milliampere of current. At 1.6 volt, ammeter shows 2.2 milliampere of current. Similarly, note down the reading by taking an interval of 0.1 volt and then plot a graph between voltage and current. Here I am going to adjust the lamp and photodiode at a separation of 16 cm. I am set this at 16 cm and repeat the same procedure for different separations as 16 cm and then 14 cm and repeat the same process. For different separations, we should note down the reading of voltage and their corresponding current. This is our experiment for reverse biasing. Now I am going to explain you about the forward biasing. For forward biasing, we have to connect this positive terminal of the photodiode to the positive terminal of photodiode, which is shown in circuit, and the negative terminal of photodiode is connected to this negative terminal of the photodiode, which is shown in circuit, and then connect the photodiode with the circuit. This connection is for forward biasing. Now our apparatus is ready for recording the reading in forward biasing. For forward characteristic curve, repeat the process as I already explained in reverse biasing for different separations between the lamp and the photodiode, as I already done between 16 cm, 14 cm, and note down the reading of voltage and their corresponding current. This is our observation table. This is for reverse characteristic curve at a separation of 18 cm. Reverse voltage and reverse current. At 0 volt, reverse current is minus 0.6 milliampere. At minus 0.25 volt, reverse current is minus 0.6 milliampere. At minus 0.5 volt, reverse current is minus 0.6 milliampere. You can see as at minus 1.4 volt, reverse current is minus 1.1 milliampere. At minus 1.5 volt, it is minus 1.5 milliampere, and so on. It is the reverse current gets decreasing. This is table for 18 centimeter. Our next table is for 16 centimeter of separation. In this table, at 0 volt, reverse current is minus 0.7 milliampere. At minus 0.25 volt, it is minus 0.7 milliampere. And after this, its value goes decreasing. This is our third table at a separation of 14 centimeter. At 4 volt, reverse current is minus 0.8 milliampere. At minus 0.25 volt, it is minus 0.8 milliampere. At minus 0.5 volt, it is minus 0.8 milliampere, and so on. After this, you can see the value of reverse current starts decreasing. This is the reverse characteristic curve of photodiode, in which voltage is taken in x-axis and current is taken in y-axis. In this curve, green colored curve is for 18 cm of separation, violet colored curve is for 16 cm of separation, and red color curve is for 14 cm of separation. In this way, we obtain this type of curve. Now coming to the observation for forward characteristic curve at a separation of 18 cm. In this, at 0 volt, our forward current is 0.4 milliampere. At 0.05 volt, it is 0.5 milliampere. At 0.1 volt, it is 0.6 milliampere. At 0.15 volt, it is 0.7 milliampere. You can see the value of current increases with the increase in voltage. This is our next forward characteristic curve for a separation of 16 centimeter. In this, at 0 volt, forward current is 0.3 milliampere. At 0.05 volt, it is 0.4 milliampere. At 0.1 volt, it is 0.5 milliampere. And you can see with the increase in the voltage, the value of current also increases. Our next table is for forward characteristic curve at a separation of 14 centimeter. In the same manner, in this curve, the value of current increases. You can see at 0 volt, it is 0.3 milliampere. At 0.05, it is 0.4 milliampere. At 0.1 volt, it is 0.5 milliampere. At 0.15 volt, forward current is 0.6 milliampere. And at 0.7 volt, it is 5 milliampere. That means the value of current increases. This is the graph for forward characteristic curve of photodiode. Here, voltage is taken in x-axis and current is taken in y-axis. The green color curve is for 18 cm of separation, violet color is for 16 cm of separation, and red color is for 14 cm of separation, and we obtain this type of curve. Now, coming to applications. These are the applications of photodiode. First, it is used in light detection system, used as a fast switch, used in solar cell. It is used in logic circuits that requires stability and high speed. It is used in object counters, burglar alarms, and in optical communication system. Here, these are the applications. Here our practical is completed. I hope you understand all the facts that I explained today. Thank you.